Hello everyone, in this tutorial I am going to make a hammer, and for this I select the front plane and the sketch, and I am going to make a square. Deselect and dimension it 150. 150 to make a asymmetry. Exit, and I am going to select the front and make a plane, and the direction I am going to make it minus 25. Sketch. I am going to make a circle. Deselect and make it as 70. Go. I am going to select the dime one plane and make minus 25 and the sketch, and I am going to sketch a circle, dimension it 100, exit the sketch. I'm going to make a select the dime 2 plane and make it as minus 40 offset, and I am going to sketch. I'm going to make a circle, deselect and change the dimension as 100 as well. Exit. Now I am going to make a boundary blend, and on these curves I am going to select that circle, keep control key, that circle and that circle. Okay, now I am going to select right plane, sketch, and I am going to project that arc and that square, and I am going to sketch a arc between those two lines and use that one. It's okay, and I'm going go back to the sketch definition and delete those two lines. And exit the sketch. Now I am going to sweep blend, and as the trajectory it is already selected, and sections I am going to select selected section and use that circle and insert that square, and use it and that one. It should appear something, but the reference is correct. The reason that it doesn't accept with the Swepland because it was with the Swepland, that is because it make it solids, and for this I must use the same boundary blend, and for this I am going to mirror that curve through top plane and OCO. Now I am going to boundary blend, and as curve I select that one, keep control key that one, and select the guide, select that one and that arc. Now we have the the surface. Now I am going to select the front plane. It doesn't accept. I am going to select front plane and zoom all, and I am going to make it as -100, -100. And we are going to zoom all, zoom back. It's too short. Make it as -150. -150. OK. And sketch on that plane. Sketch. Okay, and I'm going to make a rectangle, deselect, and change that one as 5, that one as 2.5, that one as 20, and that one as 40. Exit. Now I am going to select the top plane, select and sketch, and I am going to project that one and that line, and close. I'm going to make an arc between that point to that point and make it so. Exit. I must go back to the sketch and delete that sketch, delete that line. The reference hasn't been selected. I have a top plane and I use top plane, and I use front plane. Solve. OCO close. Now I exit, and I am going to boundary blend, and I am going to select the guide I am going to use. That one. It should appear something. Okay, cancel. It doesn't make a loop. And I am going to select the top plane again. Okay, it was that is because it is in the center, and I can I cannot make a mirror, and I must delete that arc, and I am going to select that top plane and make a plane, and I use it 50. Press OK, and I am going to sketch. And I am projecting that one and zoom in. Select those two lines and delete. It is okay now, and I am going to mirror that one through the top plane. As you see, that corner, it doesn't lie on this one, and I am going to select that one. It is sketch and edit definition, and I am going to change that one as 100 and that one as 50. Now it is correct. Now it lies on that. Now I am going to insert boundary blend, and I select that square and that rectangle, and in the guide curve I am going to select that one and that one. Now I have my hammer. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.